welcome. Well, Dame Letty, don't take too much now.
I suppose he's relieved to be out of the way.
Yeah, he's okay. I keep finding him reading the Bible, though. I don't know whether I ought to be worried about that now.
Well, why don't you ring up the Archbishop of Canterbury's mother and ask if she worries about it?
Very funny.
Where have you been?
She's here, okay.
She was supposed to come back in first thing.
I didn't want to be here any longer than I had to be.
You don't have to be here at all.
Shut up. Not today, eh?
Right. It's time to get you two ladies into your gowns.
Oh, I've seen you look worse after a Sunday morning training.
Oh, I think you both better take it easy for a while.
Look, I'm playing football again. And that's all that matters. And if you're lucky, I'll buy you all a yacht if the going gets good.
Not before I get my new kitchen and conservatory.
Now, don't you see what I'm getting at? I mean, we're settled now, we're happy. Why couldn't it have happened now instead of then?
Because life just doesn't work like that.
And what if he feels an ache, like I do, like something's missing? Maybe the most important part of him?
Look, you've got to stop this. Just accept what you have and accept what you can't have.
Why can't I? Because it happened before I met you and you hate that.
Lolly's hospitalised the cop.
Well, I'm afraid we have not been successful with Beth. Magog is dead. Must have got to the milk. Beth, however, seems to be all right.
Like I said, we can get you to somewhere that's safe. But he's dangerous. And it's not just me he's after. Eric knows he was fitted up. And if he gets to... Gets to who?
You said he was fitted up. By someone you know?
No.
Come on, Tina.
Eric was innocent.
If you know anything that can assist us in finding your husband, we need to hear it.
Who fitted Eric up, Tina?
A Mr. Meadows stitched him up. Stuff planted on him. Eric was never near that robbery, let alone do murder.
Jack Meadows?
Yeah, that's him. My husband was innocent. I know for a fact Meadows was offered an alibi that would have cleared Eric. He buried it and Eric went down.
I'm so sorry.
So, let me get this right. I'm supposed to forgive you just so that you don't spend the rest of your life looking like a fool, hmm? Well then, who's going to stop me looking like a fool?
You're right. You are right. You are right. I'm sorry. I mean, it were only... You know.
You are a lying, cheating, lazy git, Terry.
Oh, no, I am. But I can change. And maybe, just maybe, if you forgive me, I can make a fresh start without all this.
No. No, of course not. I'm glad that you
got... And it's very good sex as well.
Fine. Well, if you can remember what type of HRT you're taking, then I can prescribe it.
Oh, I think I've embarrassed you, haven't I?
No. No, it's fine.
And you do have real patience to think about.
Well,
I'll, we'll just do lunch sometime, all right? I'll make the reservations, you tell me when.
Half an hour?
Oh, perfect. Perfect.
I mean, maybe that's what you should be asking yourself. Did I choose the best for me? Because you know what? I've got news for you. We just have our choices and the actions that result from them. I mean, look around. Just because there's gold bars, it doesn't make this place any less of a prison. What's your name, anyway? If you're going to rob me, you should at least have the decency to inform me who you are.
Go inside and stay there till we've located him. Please, the matter's in good hands.
Jimmy! Jimmy!
Oh, come on, Murphy. Let's talk some sense, shall we?
Jimmy! Take us in there, he's got Jimmy! Dacon's got Jimmy!
Golden! Golden, open this door!
Look at this hair, it's hideous, isn't it?
It's not hideous. It's not very nice, though. It's a bit too sticking out. Maybe it's the wrong size.